So today I'm going to be making a big and this is going to be a cosplay wig. Bright red hair. Oh, it is synthetic hair. But I can apply heat to it. I can curl it or I can straighten it. So for the cosplay wig, it's gonna be straight. And I don't know if you guys watch Black Butler or heard it, but I'm going to be making a Madam Red cosplay wig. Using this hair. So, of course, to make a wig, you're gonna need hair. Also, need a head. Also, oh, this is a dome pack, and it looks just like that. It does stretch. And I'm basically gonna sew the hair onto this dome cap. And let's see. So a lot of the times when I make wigs, I make it lace. So this is like a lace cap. So I would usually sew the hair onto this and then ventilate strand by strand on this lace, you see it? But this is not going to be an everyday wig, and also I've used this hair before and I don't like I don't really like it like that, and I also don't like to ventilate it. So I'm not going to be doing that. I'm going to be sewing it on. And this is the thread I use. And I get this from the beauty supply store. They got smaller ones, but I get the big jumbo ones because I make a lot of wigs. And here I have all of my needles and like straight pins. So these are the type of needles I'm using. I always have more than one I'll show you that. This one has thread on it. So using those needles. And for right now, that's it. I will be using other things, but I'll see what I'm gonna do as I go along, because sometimes I'll show you it. Sometimes I use these clips and they look like this. And you sew it on the wig in different places, that way it can just comb right in. So I might use that. Yeah. I think that's it. So I'm gonna get started for now. Okay guys, this is the head I use. It is a styrofoam head. You can see it peeking through. However, I made it more glitterized. Also, if you have a styrofoam head that is beat up, this one was, doing this to it just fixes it up. I have a whole video on it, and I think I'll make a video on this channel as well for it. So the reason why I'm using this one is because you see I have this already. The styrofoam heads are small, so I basically have this on there and it makes it bigger. And it also follows the hairline of my hairline pretty much. So I'm gonna put the dome cap on it. And start sewing the wig on. Okay, so I have it pinned down, and let me cut. So I think I am gonna actually add this piece of lace. I said I was not gonna ventilate, but I think I am. I want to create a more natural closure part up here. Even though the wig is going to have bangs, I don't really like having a wig without a visible natural looking part. So I'm probably going to for sure do the middle part. I'm not sure if I'm gonna take it down all the way here, but I'm gonna use this piece because I want it. The lace part is actually gonna come out smaller. It's not gonna come out this size because I'm gonna sew this piece of lace down. What I do, I'm gonna kind of fold it properly. Fold it a little. And I'll show you guys that, but for right now, I'm just gonna start sewing on the hair. Okay, I just wanna show you guys this. So here you see I have multiple needles and they already have the thread on it. This is how long. So I make it kind of long. I know some people make it longer than this, but I don't really like to do it too long because I don't want it to get tangled. But I do this that way when I'm sewing on the hair, I don't have to constantly be re-threading one needle, one or two. So I definitely have a lot of needles, but I will probably thread, I have five here, and I'm probably gonna thread about four or five more. That way, when I'm sewing, I could just keep the flow going, and I don't have to keep, like I said, keep rethreading the same one or two needles. So then I have this styrofoam head. I just stick them in here. That way, it's like in place and organized. And also, if I don't finish doing the wig, I can just have this styrofoam head, move it to the side, and half thread readily available, and not worry about it getting like tangled and wasting a thread. So yeah. So usually I like to I will put the styrofoam head on my lap and sew. So I'm gonna do that, but right now I'll show you guys how I started. And I have this long piece. Some people like to cut it. Personally, I don't like to cut it. I mean, most people don't like to cut their wefts. For me, I don't care because I'm making this wig and it's synthetic and I know I'm probably not gonna use the hair again. So I don't mind cutting it. Some people do the fold over method. I don't really care about that. So also, let me see. So I'm gonna go from ear to ear for right now. And you know, some people like to go all the way to the top, but I'm not gonna do that either. I'm gonna hold this in place. And I just use straight pins, T-pins, whatever you have to hold the web in place. This is awkward doing it like this on my stand. I have it ear to ear, and like I said, some people fold it over and keep going. I'm not doing that. I'm gonna cut this piece off and start sewing it on. So I did a few, I had to pause it though because noise outside, but I take the needle and go through the cap. This is like a little awkward holding it on the stand because I'm trying to hold the head because I actually made this stand. So the head doesn't fit properly unless I stick something else like in between there. But I'm not gonna do that right now. So once I get to like almost, you can see the thread is little. So I pull it through and then I'm gonna stick the needle through that little loop. And I usually do that a couple of times. Sometimes see the needle's too big and you don't have enough space. But it's okay. And then I'm going to just take my scissors and then I also make a knot with that. And we could double knot, triple knot, whatever. I just try to make sure it's as secure as possible. So then, even though I did all of that, once I continue on, I have my next needle. So once I continue on, I actually make this flat, put it towards this way and start sewing over that while I'm sewing the hair to the dome cap. Just for like maximum security. So I'm gonna stick it through that. And then this is very awkward with how I'm doing it. But you see that's the remaining thread of the last needle I just used. So I just sew it down as I'm sewing the rest of the web. And that way also I don't have like little pieces sticking out or so then after I get here, I just continue to add more hair. Like I said, some people do fold over. I do that sometimes, like if I'm gonna use the hair, maybe if I might use the hair again to make a different wig, or like, I don't know, it really depends, but this is cheap hair, so I don't care about cutting the wefts. And also, this hair doesn't really shed, even though it's cheap hair. So if I cut the wefts, I don't get a lot of shedding. Like, let me see. Yeah, a few strands. But see, nothing else. So I'm gonna continue sewing. And yeah, I have the first part. I'm gonna show you guys real quick though. Hold on. So I'm gonna keep going around once I get to like up here. And then I'm gonna figure out, because I'm still unsure of how much of the front I'm gonna do lace. Even though it's gonna be a little bit, I'm still figuring out how I'm gonna maneuver that. So I'll be right back. Okay, guys, so this is what I have so far. I only sewed on 2 rolls, and then I have this 3rd roll. Basically, I have a pendant in place. It makes it easier for me to just sew it on and not have to hold or keep pulling the hair up. See, so the weft is in a straight line how I want it. I'll probably add another pin here because I'm actually going to finish it tomorrow, so when I come back, it's gonna be daylight. I don't know if you notice, but you see I'm losing like daylight, and I actually like making my wigs with like natural lighting. I have bright light, but I like to use the natural lighting. Also, when I record making wigs, I like to use the natural light, but I'm also gonna start going more up the front, and I have them spaced apart pretty good, probably about 2 fingers each, and I need to make sure I have enough hair for the whole wig. 1, 2, I don't want to make it too bulky. I don't want, this hair is already thick and it gets full, so also I'm gonna cut it, so I don't want it to be like too bulky and too thick. So making sure I do about 2 fingers spaced apart, and then after I finish doing the whole thing, I'm gonna see what I have left over. I'm gonna see if I need to add any more hair, which I'm probably not going to need to, but I'm gonna make sure I have enough hair and it's not too bulky. So this is it so far. And I'm gonna sew this last track in and be back tomorrow. Okay guys, so this is the wig so far. It's the next day, cause like I said, I like do my wigs in natural light. And my room actually gets a lot of light, but I have to shade down, otherwise it'll be too bright for you to see. Oh. I did 1 more row. I have to finish showing it, but I'm starting to go towards the front now because actually I didn't have as much hair as I thought I did. So I'm gonna have to, I'm not gonna be able to ventilate probably, like the part like I said I would. And I'm gonna have to speed up the process to see how much, if the hair is even gonna be enough, which I think it is. Well, this is it so far. So this is the front, and this is how much I have left. It looks like it's a lot, but like I said, like if I put 1 row every 2 fingers, then it should be good. So I'm gonna keep sewing and I'll be back. Oh. Here it is so far. I have to finish sewing down this one little piece right here. But this is the front. Okay, so see, this is the front area, which will be the bang. So I added a couple more little pieces to the front, and then I just kept sewing around like this. See, so it's starting to cover up the gaps in the back. So I'm gonna do probably like one or two more little rows like this up here. And then I'll make a little closure part. I might be able to ventilate. I don't know if I don't know if I want to do it or not. But I'll add some more hair up here and see if it covers the gaps here, see what's left over, and then stick any little pieces that I need to cover. Like, you see this, how you can see the cap. So usually I would do that. If I had more hair, it wouldn't be a problem, but I have to really like stretch all of this hair out. So this is it so far. I uncut it. It's the front. I'm gonna cut the bangs. So I'm gonna continue sewing and I will be back.
Okay guys, so I'm doing this last few clips voiceover style because I filmed when there was a lot of noise, and I just wanted to show you guys the top area. I actually had enough hair, so I started ventilating and I basically sewed on a piece of lace, and then I started adding hair strand by strand. Usually about 2 or 3 strands per hole at a time. And yeah, this is how it looks, and this is the final look. I cut some bangs and I'm unsure if I'm gonna go ahead and cut it like Madame Red, which was my original idea. For now I'm just gonna leave it like this, and I'm also gonna ventilate a little bit more hair at the top. But this is the final look, guys. Thanks so much for watching. See you guys next time. Bye.